Welcome, everybody, to the America Center. Come on in if you can find a spare ticket. Over 10,000 on hand for women's gymnastics, both team and all-around competition. Hi, everybody, I'm Jim Nance, and welcome. We're going to watch team competition, as always, at the Olympic Festival, East, West, North, and South competing. But also, we're going to witness some of the burgeoning young talent in the United States, some of the young talent hoping to make the U.S. squad in Atlanta in 1996. It's my pleasure to be working alongside Olympic gold medalist Julianne McNamara. It was 10 years ago this month when Julianne scored 5 perfect 10s at the Olympic Games in Los Angeles, the most in U.S. history. And Julianne, what do you expect you're going to see at this competition in St. Louis?
Well, Jim, the Olympic Festival has always been a breeding ground for up-and-coming stars. In the past, we've seen gymnasts like Mary Lou Retton, Kim Zemeckis, and Shannon Miller burst onto the scene. And there are a few gymnasts here that could make the squad in 1996. Kelly Davis is the highest-ranked gymnast here. She's a great all-around performer. And the new kid on the block, Doni Thompson, currently one of the top juniors in the country. And Jim, let me tell you, everybody that sees Doni falls in love with her.
Julianne, the women are competing on the 4 traditional Olympic events, the vault, the uneven parallel bars, the balance beam, and the floor exercise. The individual and team with the highest combined totals win gold. And we go right to the competition, competing for the North, Kristen Maloney on the floor.
This event combines power with grace, and that's why a lot of the gymnasts like this. It gives them a chance to show the artistic side of the sport. Kristen's setting up for her last tumbling run. She'll do a whip back through to a triple twisting back layout. A little short of the landing.
Kristen Maloney from Pin Argyl, Pennsylvania. Greetings from her North teammates. They've been strong on the floor, and there's a 9.70. Very good. Now, Kristen, age 13. Let's go over to a 14-year-old. This is Kristy Powell. She's competing for the East.
And watch this here. She's setting up for a men's high bar move. Eagles, Giants. Very well done. Look at the extension through her shoulders, right into a release move. Here's a second release move, a piked ganger. Very well done. Now watch this dismount. Full twisting, double back. Beautiful. What a great way to start the competition. There's nothing more to say. Watch this dismount.
Kristy resides in Colorado Springs, but is competing for the East. Gymnasts are assigned to teams to create competitive balance regardless of hometown geography. 9.775, very good. And let's move across the floor to the balance beam. This is the South's Jaycie Phelps.
She's setting up here for a punch front. It's important to keep your hips and your shoulders square over the balance beam. It's only 4 inches wide.
Julianne, action going on all 4 apparatus simultaneously. Music you hear is from the floor exercises, not for J.C. Phelps' performance.
The athletes are used to that. They practice with the noise going on while they're practicing and training. And here's her dismount. It's a very difficult one. 2 back handsprings, double back flip.
How did you like the dismount?
Great job. It's a very difficult dismount. She tumbles into a double back flip.
The beam, 9.75 for Phelps. Now, Julianne, the young woman you talked about in the opening, Doni Thompson, a teammate of Kristy Powell. They trained together back in Colorado Springs.
The thing I like about Doni on this event is she swings with a lot of fluidity. Beautiful form on her release moves. Setting up for another Takachev. She has excellent toe point, straight arms on her cast. She's just got a hitter dismount, double laid out backboard. Great landing.
Wow. That's the best performance of the first rotation.
Definitely is, and that routine will score high. And here's why. Doni does two release moves consecutively. That increases the difficulty. On the first one, she does a reverse hecht over the bar, flies over, and she does not see the bar until she re-grabs immediately into a flyaway half turn.
Hugs from her East teammates. Doni Thompson, 13 years old, moves into the early lead with a 9.85. So Thompson, Powell, Phelps, and Maloney off to a flying start after one rotation. Chow, 16 years old from San Jose, on the balance beam.
She mounts with a strength move called a plange. And she sets up here for a difficult pass. Backhand spring layout. Immediate backhand spring layout. Perfect. Gym Amy Chow is one to keep your eye on. She has world-class difficulty. Watch this full twisting backflip. Little bobble, but that is very difficult. Setting up here for another difficult move. She'll do a full twisting backhand spring. She'll swing down onto the balance beam.
Amy's mother wanted her to be a ballerina. She is graceful on this beam.
She has all the difficulty, she just needs a little more polish, but she's got everything she needs. Here's a dismount you don't see very often. Triple twisting, laid out backflip. Great job.
Amy Chow competing for the East team with a brilliant performance on the beam.
This move is reminiscent of Tatiana Gutsu, the all-round champion in Barcelona. It's extremely difficult.
And that's a 9.8. She knows all about good marks. She's a 4.0 student back in San Jose. Now, Kelly Davis competing for the West. She is the highest-ranked gymnast in this competition. She's fifth-ranked in the country.
She starts off with a very basic mount, kip. Goes uprise to handstand, reverses direction, shoots over the low bar. Nice full twisting giant. So far, we have not seen a release move where she flipped. She's lacking some difficulty here. She's got a nice dismount here. Double laid out backflip. Big step there.
Big step with Coster, Julianne.
That'll be a few tenths of a deduction.
Kelly Davis and her score, 9.7. Over to the vault, and Sarah Kane competing for the North. Now on her first vault, she had a 9.5.
She wants a better score here. Yurchenko with a half twist. Beautiful landing. That should score better. The best score counts.
Best score of two, this certainly will be the one, 9.875. One of the highest marks so far of the competition. And back to Doni Thompson, our leader after one rotation. She's on the beam, and her father, Michael Thompson, mother, Debbie, and Donnie's older brother and sister looking on.
She begins with a very difficult mount. She front flips onto the balance beam, very well done. A lot of the gymnasts opt to do easier mounts to get themselves on. That was a very daring mount. Backhand spring, two layouts.
That is stacked heavy at the top of that program.
Jim, the thing that's impressive about Doni is she's very poised. For the young age of 13 that she is, she's a very tough competitor. Half turn straddle jump. Now she's going to combine two moves here. She does a front flip right into a split jump. She's very relaxed and very comfortable, but this is a tough event. Now setting up for a dismount. Two back handsprings, double back tuck. This is showing good difficulty and good originality. She does a front flip. It's hard enough to land that, but she actually jumps out of it into a split jump. And here's two back handsprings. Very difficult that she actually does two back handsprings and tumbles into a double back flip.
They score it 9.7 for Thompson. Family's pleased, and so is Donnie. What a bubbly personality she has. To the vault now, and Martha Grubbs from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. She looks a little concerned, Julianne, because she scored 9.15 on her first vault.
But I'll tell you, Jim, this is a very difficult vault. Double twisting Yurchenko. She had a bad push off her left hand. Let's see what she does this time. Good push, great landing. I can't tell you how hard that vault is.
Martha Grubbs, the oldest competitor here. She'll turn 18 in October. And a 9.8, what an upgrade from that first vault, so that one will count. So our standings halfway through show Thompson opening up her lead to a tenth of a point after conquering the beam, but a bunched up field and hot pursuit. All signs pointing right now toward Doni Thompson. Well done, Summer, thank you. We'll save the tape. And Doni Thompson on the floor right now, 4'7", 73-pounder, who lives in Colorado Springs.
She does a triple turn here. Very big requirement. And difficult to do right before a difficult tumbling run. Full twisting, double back. Well done. Doni really plays the crowd. She's having a good time out there. She gets the crowd behind her. 1.5 twists, flip-flop layout, step out. Not as difficult as some of the middle passes you'll see. Trying to get a deep breath. 2.5 twists. Right into a front handspring.
Little Doni Thompson capturing a lot of hearts here in St. Louis. And there's Summer Reed to greet her. Coach Tom Forster. She just popped into his training academy at the age of 5, and that's how it all started. 9.85. Now back to Kelly Davis in third place.
She does the same mount we saw Doni Thompson do earlier.
Oh!
As I talked about, it's very difficult. Her hips were out of line. It pulled her off of the balance beam. That's a big deduction, 5/10 of a point.
Davis back up on the beam. Let's shift over now to Kristy Powell, Doni Thompson's East teammate and also training partner back at Tom Forster's Academy in Colorado Springs.
Jim, this is the most difficult tumbling run being done in this competition. Double layout backflip, great height. only is she powerful, but she shows a very good style. Very creative dance moves and beautiful form. Here's a second tumbling run. High front step out into a 1.5 twisting laid out front flip known as a Rudy.
This is Kristy's favorite event. She says, I can show off my personality. She is spunky and enthusiastic on the floor.
And for her young age, she shows a lot of maturity. Difficult last pass. Double cut. Beautiful. Good height. To me, that's what gymnastics is all about. Incredible power and beautiful artistry. The thing that's amazing about this first tumbling run, it actually looks like she goes higher on the second flip. She's totally laid out in the air. Beautiful form. And you're so tired at the end of a floor exercise, a minute 30, here's a big burst of energy to get great height.
And that performance by Kristy Powell merits a 9.9. How about this combo from Colorado Springs? And while Powell finished on the floor, Kelly Davis on the beam scored a 9.2, really doomed right from the start.
Well, it's a gymnast's nightmare to mount the equipment and have an immediate fall. It's so difficult to regain your concentration when you know you've fallen and you have to finish up with a routine.
Kelly drops from 3rd to 10th place. So after 3 of 4 events, Thompson has expanded her overall lead, and Kristy Powell jumped up from 14th to 6th. Kristy, how bad does she want to make the Olympic team for Atlanta? Well, 3 weeks ago, she got braces, and they're red, white, and blue. Not only that, she has a poster in her room of Atlanta. She says she thinks about it every night.
As soon as the sleep on top.
She'll perform a 1.5 twisting your chanko vault in a tuck position. Nice landing.
She has been dazzling in all 4 rotations. And after 3 rotations, she had such a commanding lead over the field that realistically the battle is for silver and bronze. And the score on the vault for Doni Thompson, 9.725, that will lock up the gold medal. Her family is thrilled and proud. Now the battle for 2nd. On the beam, Sarah Balagash. She's in 5th after 3 rotations.
This is an incredible pass, 3 layouts in a row. Two straddle jumps fulfilling a requirement. Full twisting, flip-flop.
Good finish here, and she could medal. Balagash from Allentown, Pennsylvania.
Triple twisting dismount. Didn't quite get the twist all the way around. This is an awesome pass here. She consecutively flips 3 times. She's perfectly aligned over the balance beam.
The judges say 9.725. Well done by Balagash. Also in contention for a medal, Kristy Powell.
Kristy performs the same vault as Doni Thompson, but she does in a laid out position that makes it more difficult. Beautiful vault, but that one big step on the landing.
She'll have one more pass on the vault. That's her first one. 9.775. Phelps, second coming into the last rotation. She's from Fairfield, Ohio.
Half turn out of her giant to front giant. Full twist sets up for her release move to catch a big form break there. Giant full twist right into a double back dismount.
Was it good enough?
Well, you can see the mistake here. She had a huge form break, knees completely bent as she flies over the bar. That'll be about a 2/10 deduction.
Trying to win silver, but a score of 9.65. That leaves an opening for Kristy Powell. She was 14th midway through the competition. Now she can medal with a big vault here.
Well, she's got a great vault. She just needs to stick the landing. Unbelievable.
Will it be enough? 9.9. Back-to-back 9.9s on the floor, on the vault. So Doni Thompson wins the gold. And look at Powell all the way up to silver position. Phelps claims the bronze. Let's go down to Peter Vidmar.
Well, Jim, I'm with a 1-2 punch from the East team, our all-around champion, Doni Thompson, and Kristy Powell, the runner-up. Now, Doni, you said that going into the last event, that your weakest event was vault. What was going through your mind right before that vault?
I just thought that I need to stay calm, do what I do in practice, and just land it.
And this is the first time you've done this in competition?
Yes.
That's great. Well, congratulations. And Kristy, your last two performances were 9.9s. You really came up at the end. How'd you feel?
Yeah, I feel really great. Double out was a new thing for me, and it was great. I'm so excited.
Now, both of you are on the same club team back in Colorado. That's right. Do you work out real well together? You have a great time?
Yeah. It's really fun.
Yeah.
Are you pretty competitive out there?
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, it just helps us. It's like a game we play at gym.
It works for each other and not against.
Huh. Well, that's great. Well, congratulations to both of you.
Thank you.
Jim?
All right, Peter. So an enthusiastic peek into the future of U.S. gymnastics witnessed by 10,000 here in St. Louis. They also saw the North team win the gold with Sarah Balagosh, Kristen Maloney, Kara Fry, Martha Grubbs, Kristen McDermott, and Sarah Kane. But the big story with the Olympics 2 years away, 13-year-old Doni Thompson with a smashing performance, and Kristy Powell right behind. For Julianne McNamara and Peter Vidmar, this is Jim Nance saying so long from the America Center.
And we'll have plenty.